Hello everyone, I'd like you to welcome you all to this session on Observability with Amazon OpenSearch Service. My name is Muthu Pichaimani. I'm a specialist solution architect focusing exclusively on Amazon OpenSearch Service, and I help customers build solutions with the service. This is the agenda for today's session. I'm going to be discussing about what operational analytics is and what observability is and where do they fit in. And I'm going to discuss some few use cases for observability and what are all the data or pillars of observability is. And finally, I'm going to describe some components of Amazon OpenSearch Service that helps you to accomplish observability. Finally, there is a demo that I'm going to show you that shows you how you can put all these pieces together and how you can use it to gain insight for your data. What is operational analytics? It is not a new field. It is a field that evolved from operation research from industrial manufacturing 3 or 4 decades ago. The aim of operational research was to improve the business efficiency, and similarly, the aim of operational analytics, which means applying operational research to modern day computing systems, is to improve business efficiency and/or customer experience and value. Traditionally, operational analytics has been done using batch systems where you process a large volume of data and then get some insight from it that helps you to make some business decision. The aim of operational analytics is to remove this manual process and to use machines in the process so that you can make the decisions faster and also in some way, shape or form in an automated fashion. Operational analytics falls in 3 distinct categories. The first of which is what is called as descriptive analytics. When you look at a complex system, you need to be able to describe what the system is in first place so that you can understand and characterize its behavior. All the activities that you do is covered under descriptive analytics. Next is called the predictive analytics. So once you know what the system is and you understand its behavior, then you can predict how the system is going to behave. All the activities that you do comes under predictive analytics. Finally, what is called as prescriptive analytics means that once you know what the system is, how it behaves, and you can predict what it is, if some issue were to happen, then you can be prescriptive about the solution either in a manual fashion, or you can even use the machine to take some automated decision. That's what all the activity that you do there is called as prescriptive analytics. So where does observability fit in? It fits into the category of this descriptive analytics that helps you to understand the behavior of a complex system using some data that you gather from the system itself. So what is observability? Observability, as I mentioned before, just like operational analytics, is the a measure of how well you can understand the behavior of a system or the internal states of a system from the knowledge of its external outputs without knowing how the system itself behaves. So observability is a measure of how well you can infer the state so that you can predict its behavior and finally be prescriptive about any issues where to happen. So what are some of the use cases for observability? The first and the foremost use case is the field of microservices and container. As monolithic applications gets broken down into microservices, you need to be able to know what is happening within the system. Or for example, you want to know how a request traverses to the entirety of system and how it is serviced. So that's one emerging use case where observability is used. The next is what we like to call it as a digital experience monitoring. So this is where you have applications that interacts with user, and you would like to know what the user is doing, what the user behavior is, and what part of the systems or users are more interested in. That helps you to make business decisions based on those data, or it can improve the overall efficiency of a system. The next one is what is called as operation center or AI ops or DevOps, where you can use observability to reduce your mean time to knowledge. That is, if an issue were to happen, then you can quickly identify what the issue is. And once you know that, then you can formulate a resolution and the time it takes to formulate a resolution, which is termed as mean time to resolution. The last application of data lakes, last application of observability is in data lakes, is where when you process a large volume of data and you have this large complex system interacting with each other and you'd like to know what the state of the system is in and how you can characterize the behavior so as to improve the data processing. So what data can you collect from a system to improve to understand the internal states of the system? The first and the foremost is what is called as logs. These are time series events that happened or that helps you to get an insight into what is happening in the system. These can be from your applications or infrastructure or other parts of the system. Next is metrics, which gives you a numerical measurement of your system state or the resource utilization of your system itself. And finally, the last is what is called as a trace data. It allows you to track a request as it enters your complex system and as it goes through it and finally returns after being serviced. So that's what it's called, that's the last component of observability itself. So now let's look at a architecture or what are all the components that are involved, associated, and the services that you can use to achieve or accomplish this observability within your system. The first and the foremost is to the ability to collect these three different types of data, the logs, metrics, and traces. And OpenTelemetry is an open source project that aims to do it in a vendor agnostic or in a programming environment agnostic or your infrastructure agnostic way. It's an open standard. It's aiming to be an open standard. So OpenTelemetry is a set of tools, SDKs, and agents that helps you to collect these data. So you will collect it and you will use other tool, what is called this data prepper, that allows you to change this or transform this data into a form that can be consumed by a service like Amazon OpenSearch service. We all know there are agent-based tools like FluentBit that allows you to collect metric and log data from your applications and send it to next layer or next part of the architecture itself, which is the storage layer, where you can send those, so data prepper and FluentB sends these logs and metrics and traces to storage services like Amazon OpenSearch service. And there are other services that are available that allows you to capture these metric data and store at scale, like Amazon managed service for Prometheus, where you can directly write those data as well. So once you store the data and index it, now they can be visualized, correlate, and which helps you to gain an insight. You can use, again, Amazon OpenSearch service for visualization, or there are other services like Amazon managed service for Grafana that helps you to visualize the data. You can use the metrics data coming from Amazon service for Prometheus, or you can get the traces and logs data coming from Amazon OpenSearch service. So we look at some of the components that are built inside Amazon OpenSearch service itself. The first and the foremost is what is called as Observability UI that has many different components, including what is called Event Analytics. Event Analytics is a place where you can use a language called as pipe to processing language. The example for which is shown here that allows you to pipe the data from one source to other and interact with it, filter it, and create a visualization and so on. Event Analytics is a panel that helps you to do the visualization easily using pipe processing language. We have another UI called Trace Analytics that helps you to visualize this trace data in a fashion that helps you to identify the throughput or error rate or the latency within a service very quickly. Let's go a little bit deep into what this trace analytic feature itself. Now, first and foremost, I'd like to talk about what is called as distributed tracing. As a user request enters a system, it traverses to the different parts. And parts of the system, the distributed traces or tracing refers to the method or observing the requests as they pass through the system. A trace is something that tells you a story as a or workflow as it propagates through the system. Say, for example, the user initiates a request. Let's assume there is an e-commerce application where a user is buying a data. So typically, the workflow will be like user looks at a search for a product, looks at a product, clicks on a product and then buys it, makes a payment option, and then finally the order is complete. So let's imagine the system. In this case, if the user is creating, say for example, the act of purchasing spans a set of activities that ends up calling different services. Say for example, you have to call your inventory service to reduce your inventory, or you got to call your billing service to accept the payment, and so on. So the ability to trace the request as it goes through a different part of the system is what is called as distributed tracing. So first I'd like to talk about span details. This is a UI that gives you information about span and its associated detail, A span is a single unit of work that is done within the system collectively. So this UI gives you the details about the latency, errors, and the service time summary as the request traversal system. So this span details are connected are collected through the OpenTelemetry specification, which was built from OpenTracing specification earlier. We also support different other specifications like other standards like Jaeger and Zipkin, and also provider specific specifications like X-ray and OpenTelemetry SDKs. The next part of the system is what is called a service map. This gives you an end-to-end view of your application application environment. It collects, it creates a graph through the connections, through the relationship between the different parts of a system, and provides this error rate and throughput information in such a way that you can, with a single glance, you can look at where the issues are happening within the system and so on. So this helps you to isolate the hotspot within the system based on these three different metrics. The last is what is called as trace groups. This aggregates similar traces into a trace group. And this is based on your service name or your API name and so on. So the unique thing about these trace groups is that you can monitor the performance of trace groups, and you can look at what the error rate was and the average latency and things like that. It helps you to quickly spot anomalies that is happening within your trace groups and allows you to, as I mentioned before, isolate the errors quickly. Okay. And I'm going to show a demo of a sample application that puts all this together. Here is a demo that I'm going to show you about the different components that we talked about. This is a demo of a sample application, an e-commerce application. This simulates the user behavior when he purchases an order or places an order, pays for it, and so on. This sample application is running in Amazon EKS. And all the microservices are running in a different container. And you have these services called the payment service or the authorization service and order, inventory, and so on. So using OpenTelemetry, we collect all the traces and give it to data prepper. And data prepper then prepares or transforms the data into JSON that can be written into Amazon OpenSearch service. And these containers also write logs, and these logs are connected, collected by FluentBit, and they are written onto Amazon OpenSearch service. So this is how the sample application looks like. In the sample application, I just have a few buttons that simulates the user behavior. So if you clicking off each button simulates a user action here. Now I'm going to create an order and then check out an order, and then pay for it. That completes one normal logical flow of operations. Then I'm gonna log on to OpenSearch service here, dashboards, and it's already logged in with a username here. Then I'm going to jump into the OpenSearch observability UI, which you can reach by going to the left-hand side and clicking observability here. And it lands in the event analytics page by default. And there are a few other UI components called trace analytics, operation panels, and so on. Let's look at trace analytics. This gives you a tracing dashboard that shows you all the trace groups. Trace groups are these collected traces that perform on logical operations or grouped by the API name or the service name. So in this hypothetical situation, the clients are complaining that their order checkout is taking a long time, and we are going to see which service is responsible for it. And just by looking at the trace groups here, I can see from the dashboard that the checkout, client checkout operation is the one that is having a 100% error rate. The pay order and the create order, they are working fine. And this UI also shows you the metrics or the latency over a period of time and the average latency that it is taken to. And again, the next view is what is called the service maps that gives you an overall end-to-end view of a system and how your services interact. In this case, the front-end client or your front-end code interacts with the authentication service and also with an order service and a database and so on. So, and also it shows you these error rate and throughput metrics. And the darker it is, the higher its latency. And you can very quickly say that the hotspot is only in this order on the front end services.
Then if you select this error rate, you can see that the payment service is the one that has the highest error rates of all. Then you can quickly zero in on which is the service that is having error. Now, so that is the service map view. Next, I'm going to look at the traces here. The client checkout trace, it's associated with one trace. I'm going to click on those trace and gives me the trace ID. And then when you click on that one, it can give you all the trace and span details here. For example, this also shows a view where it gives you the time that each service, time spent in each service. In this case, the client codes takes a lot long time, and the payment services, we spend 23% of time there. And finally, the analytics services collects the logs and initiates other metadata associated with the services. It spends in one the rest of the time here. These are the interesting span details that shows you a timeline view of what is happening over here. So the root span is this client checkout, and this initiates a HTTP post, and that calls the payment service, and which is showing an error here. So this is a nice timeline view of span associated. You can also see it in terms of a span list over here. So the next component, we already saw event analytics, and you can use your PPL, the pipe processing language, to write your statements and then show, interact with it in easy fashion here. And you can also store and retrieve those visualizations that you create using this panel, the queries in the visualization panel. So as I mentioned, there are other operational panels that you can create dashboards out of that you created with the trace analytics and event analytics. And the notebooks helps you to organize or nice tell a story of doing a root cause analysis or something like this. So that's the quick demo I had. Thank you, everyone.
I hope this has been useful in getting introduced to what is observability and what are all different components in Amazon OpenSearch service. As a next step, you have this lab that you can go and play around with to understand and build the components for yourself. Thank you so much.